Hello, my name is Emily Cantillon. I'm a teacher of the visually impaired for Perkins School for the Blind. Today, I will be speaking to you on Perkins CVI assessment area, visual fields. Impact of visual field. Here we have an image of a student with a black tray and an iPad tablet in their right visual field. This assessment area evaluates the availability of the student's visual fields, peripheral and central, as it relates to awareness, established and/or maintained attention, and recognition. What the research says: the central visual functions of visual acuity, contrast sensitivity, and color vision, as well as the peripheral visual fields, can be afflicted by lesions or dysfunction affecting the optic tracts, lateral to nuclei, optic radiations, or primary visual cortices. The superior optic radiations can also be affected, causing lower visual field impairment, which ranges between complete to solely rendering the feet invisible when walking. A lack of visual field due to CVI may also impair visio-motor coordination, as the low vision is insufficient to allow movement to be accurately visually guided, giving a false impression of clumsiness. Visual fields. Here we have an image of a table with a black mat. On the black mat is a silver spoon with a red handle, next to a red plate. In front of this is a black trifold board. Some individuals with CVI may have increased visual attention and or recognition in a specific visual field. They may have clinically measured full visual fields, but demonstrate functional difficulties. They may have strong central vision function, but reduced peripheral vision. They may rely solely on their peripheral vision, resulting in decreased detail vision. Visual fields. Visual field may be further impacted by reduced contrast sensitivity, ocular motor challenges, visual motor difficulties, visual clutter, competing sensory stimuli, visual fatigue, motion in the environment. Observable behaviors. Here we have an image of a student holding a gold ornament in their right hand, holding it high in their right visual field. Some individuals with CVI may have a full visual field that becomes reduced when fatigued or when confronted with increased visual clutter. They may position their eyes to a particular side when viewing. They may bump into door frames or other objects on one side. They may fall off curves or miss other subtle changes in depth. They may miss content on one side of a book or food on one side of their plate. They may tilt their head to a particular side. They may demonstrate difficulty with stairs. Compensatory strategies. Here we see an image of a student in a grocery store using a white cane. Some individuals with CVI may engage in whole head movement when scanning, use upper or lower limbs to gain tactile information, use a long cane or other device to support safe navigation, rely on methodical search strategies, rely on memory or familiarity to support travel. Examples. Here we see an image of a student and staff member sitting around a Velcro slant board. Student is gesturing to the board with right hand. Use of a slant board or other raised platform can help bring materials out of the lower visual field for viewing. Positioning of the instructor should be strategically considered for the available visual field of the student. Some students may prefer that the staff member reposition themselves to their less accessible side to decrease clutter. Voices of CVI. Here's a quote from an adult with CVI. "When I am rested and happy, I see clearly, except for the visual field loss. My acuity is fine. But when I have visual fatigue, it's like looking through a straw. Usually, when I'm not fatigued, it's like looking through an empty toilet paper roll. I can only speak about my experience. This can be different for others with CVI. I have an extremely limited visual field. It gets all fuzzy." Another quote from a young adult with CVI. "I have trouble with my lower visual field. I like things to be put up on a slant board so that I can see it better. I can see some things that are higher in my visual field, but it depends on which side it's on. Higher up on the left is a problem." There are many current researchers looking at the impact of visual fields on individuals with CVI. Every child with CVI is teachable, and every child has a right to a meaningful and accessible education. We, here at Perkins, are urgently confronting the leading cause of childhood blindness. Join us.